Hey guys, today we're going to talk about making your factory speakers sound better. We are back working on the Honda Civic again, and we've updated the head unit. We've also updated the front speakers, the JL Audio C1s. But we are going to now upgrade the rears, but we're not going to change them. The reason why is I want to build a budget system. I also don't want rear tweeters. The reason why I don't, having these speakers already bounce off the glass is throwing off my imaging for the front. So I had to fade it to the front by about on the Kenwood front seven, basically, till it sounded more balanced. A lot of these sedans, when you have rear speakers, if you keep them balanced and you amplify them, it'll bounce off the back glass and it'll hit the driver. And it just, to me, it sounds funny. I don't know why a lot of people want to upgrade their rear speakers so much. So we're trying to create a balance system. So here we're using sound deadening. I had some scraps I've put on the rear deck. We're trying to reduce resonance. If you guys watch my exhaust video, you'll see how important sound quality, even on an exhaust system, by reducing resonance is. And we are now adding, besides sound deadening here on the actual metal, we're adding our fast rings inside a plastic baffle and around to help funnel the sound through. You guys can see here is my three-piece kit. So this is gonna go around the surround. We've cut this, and you can see that the factory does have foam, but it's old, so we might as well just put the new foam on, and this is going to help seal it in our plastic baffle. I then cut half of this and placed it into the plastic baffle. These things are huge, so I didn't need to use it, so this is just a spare for me now. I know it sounds a little bit counterintuitive, like I just said I wrecked the imaging and now I'm trying to focus it more, but I still have rear passengers in this vehicle and I want to see how much more sound quality I can pick up just by adding in these fast rings. If I can reduce any back waves with the foam inside our baffle down here, then I'm all for it because we're not spending a lot to get better sound quality. You can see from factory that they have already tried to contain the sound by just in their mold alone, which is a great idea. Now with the foam ring, we're going to absorb any waves that go sideways. We're going to focus it into the cab. So we're going to try to pick up on mid-range bass, even though we're not trying to focus so much on the rear speakers. There's a few reasons why I kept the factory speakers. One, they're a lot cheaper. Two, they don't have a tweeter, so we're not going to have as many high-pitched frequencies hitting that back glass. Three, they're also significantly more efficient. So since we're not going to be amplifying these rear speakers, we're probably going to run a three channel, or we're going to do a self-powered sub. We're going to go on the cheap on this sound system. This will help make sure that they are actually getting powered properly because they don't need much power to run in the first place. With our baffles in the trunk, there are definitely pros and cons. One of the pros are it's going to sound more clear, and we're also protecting the speaker if in case you were to put anything in the trunk, anything hits it, nothing's gonna damage it. Also, if we have a subwoofer in here, the waves from the subwoofer cannot distort the speaker. The cons are you're gonna lose a lot of low-end bass. So if you do this and you're not adding a subwoofer and you are relying on your rear speaker, especially if you have 6x9s to produce lower-end bass, these are actually gonna cut down quite a bit because the airspace is not quite enough. Even though it looks almost relative to a subwoofer box and a subwoofer, it's not. These are far too small. So you will forgo that. So keep that in mind. If you are relying on that bass from the rear speakers and you like how it sounds, you might not want to put these in. Upon reinstallation, you're probably going to find that your panels are harder to put in. That's because you could cut down the foam, but we want as much pressure as possible because when we add tension to these plastic panels, they don't resonate. Like this one doesn't have anything on it, but see how higher pitch that sounds then? This is a lower pitch. That's just by getting tension from those fast rings on here. We didn't add any sound deadening to the plastic itself. If you guys are trying to reduce a lot of that rattle, adding sound deadening to the metal and to the plastic will help. Even in areas like this, we didn't add anything because we're trying to, you know, go as low buck as possible. But these are things that you guys can do. So it definitely sounds a lot clearer in here having all this done, but we did lose that lower end bass that these rears were producing, but that's okay because we're going to put something either in the trunk or underneath the driver's seat. I haven't decided yet, but you know, if you're trying to pick up on clarity, you're definitely going to gain there. So you guys have to really consider how are you building your system and what you want out of it. I find that trying to have the rear speakers do as much as the fronts just sounds weird. It almost sounds like someone's talking. Like it's like trying to listen to a conversation in front of you and then someone's talking behind you. It's like that, but everyone's in unison. So this is the system that I'm trying to build, is where we're just making the rear a nice complementing filler. So guys, would you do this to your car? Would you amplify the fronts, keep the rear stock? Would you disconnect the rears, or would you want everything loud? Comment below, I'd like to know. If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way at all times, you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section and it keeps applying it to different vehicles. Yeah.